Hey everybody, it's Mike Venus, and I'm back, right? And I must have stirred the pot last week when it came to breaking down my live set. And some people was not happy, bro. Especially my decision to make the Force the drum machine and to make the Akai Force, Akai NPC Live 2, a synthesizer. Now, the Hairbrush Looper board, I didn't get much heat on that because it is what it is. It's just capture audio. You know what I'm saying? That's what I use it to do. You know, it is what it is. If I'm doing ambience or if I'm doing my ambient techno or, you know, whatever this is, whatever I want it to be, and then with the drums and the pads and, you know, floaty stuff, so be it. It can capture it. I didn't get heat off of that. I don't think that community is really that crucial on how it's used. I think it is what it is. It's a big-ass looper board. It just captures audio. You got a lot of routing options. It's great, right? But I've noticed on this channel, when I talk about either one of these devices, I'm not confusing anybody. Hopefully I'm not. I like both machines, but both of the machines, as much as they have a lot of pros, they have cons. And you know, the way I have this set up is to complement each other. Yes, I know they each can do the same thing. They can do everything. But it's just easier to do it. Drums on this, on Force, synths, pads, melody, bass on the NPC. Now, in the future, Lord's will, I can get me some Zoya pedals. That's what I really want. And we can get this processing thing going on and get it real crazy up in this piece. But till then, I'm going to use my devices. I use what I have. So what I have is these two devices and my launch pad. Now, I don't think I really explain what the purpose of the launch pad is. Obviously, you know, it's a MIDI controller. I say it's one of the best grid universal MIDI controllers, especially the Launchpad Pro Mach 3, the newest one, which is really sleek. I like the way it looks, and I like the pads, and the response is very great. Pro. This is programmable. You know, you can make many customized pages. The four track sequencer is great because, like I said, typically when, usually when I make my tracks, I like to have a pad, right? So let's just demonstrate this real quick. So let me go to sequencer. Let me clear everything. Right, and pad one or track one, I always like to set up to be my pads. So let's just do something real simple. I'm gonna set it to 8 bars, right? And we're gonna do this in minor. So we're gonna go, let's go C minor. 7. This shit hella weird. Right. 2. Let's go E flat. from E flat. We're gonna go to G minor. Right, so, and then that's my chord progression, which is gonna be really weird. And then we're gonna add some mutation to it, you know, we're gonna add it more on the latter chords then on the probably go half with this. Right, those are the chords. So then for the bass line, right, we'll go over here and we're gonna go to the patterns and we're gonna make that a single note. We're gonna do eight and we're just gonna put a C note, right, and we're gonna make it one bar. Some mutation it is, just to give it some flavor. All right. Sure, this is 8 bars. It is 8 bars. Okay, and let's just start out with that. Slow this down some. Or, but yet what we're gonna do, keep that going. Alright, so you got the pad going. Got my drums going in the back. Got that Vice City's 80 thing, like Grand Theft Auto. let's make a melody. Go. Don't play my face, bro. Thank you. killing it. Yes. So that's what I'm going for. Sorry, I just kind of got carried away. Wasn't planning on that. Just wanted to talk a little bit about a setup and how I'm improving it. But yeah, that's the hype synth on here. You already know my drum synth. and I'm going to improve on it. And yeah, that's me sequencing from the Launchpad. It's a great tool, but I'm just using what I have, and hopefully it inspires others to be resourceful, to embrace the limitations of the gear you might have, you know, and rock out, kill it. Oh yeah, go check out Cause No Over Fears. That's where I got this hat at. Straight fire. Straight fire. It's super cool. Right? We're working on other colors, but this is fire. All right, that's the logo. Support. Go check it out. I'll leave the link to the website so you can purchase. And yeah, I'll be back. We'll talk more about this. Till next time, Mike out.